Hello and welcome back to Beyond the Headlines. I'm Nikita Arora. The rupee this week has crossed the 72 mark against the dollar, its lowest ever. The government is scaling new lows, and what's surprising is that there's been a complete U-turn by the BJP on this issue since 2013. At that time, when the rupee was doing better than it is now, the BJP called it a panic situation, they demanded accountability from the Prime Minister directly, and they badgered the UPA for poor policies and for corruption. Today, it's a whole different story.
रुपये की कीमत जिस तेजी से गिर रही है और कभी कभी तो लगता है कि दिल्ली सरकार और रुपये के बीच में कंपटीशन चल रहा है, किसकी आबरू तेजी से गिरती चली जा रही है, कौन आगे जाएगा।
नेपाल का रुपया कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, बांग्लादेश की करेंसी को कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, पाकिस्तान की करेंसी को कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, श्रीलंका की करेंसी को कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, हमारे अड़ोस पड़ोस में छोटे 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 देशों को भी डॉलर के मुकाबले में कोई नुकसान नहीं हो रहा है।
क्विक फैक्ट चेक। If you look at the currencies that the Prime Minister has mentioned in the 6 months preceding his speech, all currencies except Bangladesh had seen a dip in their value. Moving on.
और मैंने साफ मांग की है, ये सिर्फ आर्थिक कारणों से नहीं हुआ है, ये आपकी भ्रष्ट राजनीति जो चली है दिल्ली से, उसका इसके अंदर बहुत बड़ा रोल, बहुत गंभीरता से आरोप लगा रहा हूं।
So at that time, it was the UPA's corrupt politics that was causing the fall in the rupee. Not so much the global economic factors. Today we are of course being told that it is all a result of global economic conditions.
If you look at the domestic economic situation and the global situation, there are virtually no domestic reasons which are attributable to this. The reasons are global.
So absolutely no domestic reasons. Only global. Now, no one is disputing that there are external conditions that are causing the fall in the rupee. We know that there is an ongoing trade war between America and China, and the dollar has strengthened against a number of different currencies. There is a crisis in Argentina and Turkey, and that has affected the currency in a number of different emerging markets as well. And the crude oil prices have also increased in the last couple of months to $77 per barrel. But to be fair, the crude oil prices between 2012 and 2014, when the UPA was in power, were consistently crossing $100 per barrel, and the rupee was doing better then. Having said that, it is a little bit dishonest and arrogant for the government to claim that it has absolutely no responsibility for this fall in the value of the rupee. There are at least two domestic reasons that experts agree on. One is that India has a widening trade deficit, which means that our imports far exceed our exports. Our import bills are rising, and our exports contribution to the GDP has hit a 14-year low in the first quarter of 2018. Secondly, our foreign portfolio investments have seen a decline, which means that people are not investing in our country as much anymore. In fact, it's 1/5 of the value of the same time last year. So either the government is failing to instill confidence, or it is failing to make the return on investments more attractive. Either way, both these reasons are domestic, and the government must take responsibility for at least these two. Even Yashwant Sinha, the former finance minister, tweeted that when the rupee was depreciating under the UPA, Prime Minister Manmohan Singh was responsible. But today, it is all a result of global factors. Who's to say Goebbels is dead? The bottom line is that we are the second worst performing currency among the BRICS nations and the worst performing Asian currency. So under similar global economic conditions, our neighbouring countries still seem to be doing better than us. We had strong reactions from the BJP back in 2013, when the rupee was hitting between 68 and 69. In fact, I want you to watch these two videos, one by Mr. Jaitley in Parliament, where if you simply replace Prime Minister Manmohan Singh with Prime Minister Modi, it would hold equally true today. And the second is of Sushma Swaraj in Parliament as well, who's going all guns blazing against the UPA.
My suggestion, sir, is it's a panic situation
एंड देयरफॉर द कंट्री वांट्स नॉट मियरली अ डिस्कोर्स ऑन इकोनॉमिक थ्योरी बट द कंट्री वुड लाइक टू नो फ्रॉम द ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर एज टू व्हाट द प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज इन माइंड विद रिगार्ड टू रिवाइविंग दिस सिचुएशन. In a democracy, the buck stops with the prime minister. It doesn't disappear with the prime minister.
रुपए ने इस तरह से फिसलना शुरू किया, इस तरह से गिरना शुरू किया कि 67 रुपए से फिसलता 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 रात को 68.89 पर आकर खड़ा हो गया. कल तो टीवी लगाने से डर लग रहा था क्योंकि हर आधे घंटे बाद 10 पैसे गिर जाते थे, 50 पैसे गिर जाते थे, 60 पैसे गिर जाते थे.
So completely agree with Mr. Jaitley. The buck must stop with the Prime Minister, whether it's Prime Minister Manmohan Singh or Prime Minister Modi. But of course, we haven't heard a word from Prime Minister Modi yet. As for Sushma Swaraj, she was afraid to even turn on the TV when the rupee fell from 67 to about 69. And today we are being asked to stay calm when the rupee has crossed the 72 mark. The next video is my favorite because hypocrisy is at its peak.
You would imagine with a falling rupee that the exports will increase because your goods gets cheaper and there is a temptation abroad to buy your goods. But no, people are not wanting to buy your goods. Your imports are increasing but your exports are not increasing in spite of the falling rupee. It's a very grave situation. A situation which we are periodically saying nothing to, we are periodically being told by the government nothing to worry, everything is in place, we are taking care of the economy, and we've been repeatedly told that the fundamentals of the Indian economy are very strong and therefore nothing can hurt us. What more can hurt us?
With the rupee at 62, you don't want to accept that the fundamentals of the economy are strong and that it will bounce back. Fair enough. But at 72, Mr. Jaitley is trying to sell us the exact same logic. The other point Ms. Sitaraman is making is that with the value of the rupee depreciating in 2013, our exports should become more lucrative. Our exports should basically go up because it's cheaper to buy from us. True. And oh my God, look, the UPI has not only failed to strengthen our rupee, even our exports are not going up. So it's a double whammy. But like we've discussed before, that's the exact same situation right now. Our rupee is depreciating, it's even lower than it was in 2013, and our exports are not going up, they're dwindling, and our import bills are rising. So if the government was responsible then, the government should also be responsible now. Economists and experts have pointed out that there are certain factors right now that are in the BJP's favor. For example, our current account deficit and our fiscal deficit are in a slightly better position than they were under the UPA. Also, the crude oil prices currently are better than they were then. From about $100 then, they've dropped to about $75 a barrel now. Even then, the side effects are going to be equally damaging. Domestic inflation, costlier imports, cheaper exports. The truth is that the Indian educated middle class forgets the government mistakes as long as it doesn't pinch their pockets. But the moment it starts pinching their pockets, they begin to react. In 2014, when the UPA was ousted from power, the rupee averaged at 59 against the dollar in the month of May. Today, it has climbed to 72. So Modi may not have an election that is as easy as 2014 if this continues. One important point is that the BJP played the role of a strong opposition. They created a hue and cry and almost brought the parliament to a standstill on the issue of the depreciation of the rupee. The Congress is completely failing to raise this question and demand accountability from the BJP and press them for answers. They almost have become complacent and they've become a passive, toothless opposition. If they want to have any chance in the 2019 elections, they really need to step it up. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, share and subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video.